All right, this is fourth grade, module 4, lesson 16, and we're going to continue talking about quadrilaterals. Only this time we're going to be using some square and triangular grid paper to kind of reason about the attributes of these quadrilaterals. And basically what this means is, okay, in the 26 years of my teaching, sometimes it drives me crazy when I ask my students to draw a rhombus, and they know what a rhombus is, but their rhombus that they draw is just ugly as all heck. And so we're going to, in this lesson, reason about the attributes of these basic figures and then use special grid paper to draw better versions of these things so they don't have to look so ugly. Let's get started on this. So I'm going to start off with some triangular paper. And if we're told to draw a rhombus, I can look at this triangular paper, and we want our students to be able to just kind of like see a rhombus in the midst of all this grid. Now, the idea is a rhombus has to have four sides that are all the exact same length, and we're supposed to have, so it's like a square, but it's not necessarily going to have 90-degree angles. And so one way to draw that is to start here, and you'll see, okay, what I've done is I've drawn like a three-unit length line. And let's see if I can show it. One, two, three. So there's my three-unit length line. And so from here, I need to draw another one that is also three units. So I'm going to draw three units. One, two, three. And then I'm going to complete that on this side. One, two, three. And then complete it on this side. One, two, three. Now I now have my rhombus because I've got all four sides are the same length. I've got this side is parallel with this side, and I've got this side is parallel with this side. I now have a rhombus. Now, if we wanted to draw a rectangle on this same triangular paper, now it's going to get a little on the ugly side because, of course, a rectangle has to have some 90-degree angles, and I don't see any 90-degree angles here. So what that's going to mean is, oh, let's say I'm going to start here, and I'll draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I've drawn a 5-unit line, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab it. I'm going to grab it here, and let's see if I can grab it, and I'm going to make a copy of it. And let's see, ungroup, and I'm going to click on this guy. There we go. And oops, yikes. There. And I'm going to duplicate it. All right. So, woohoo. Now I got this guy. And so it's the same. And I'm going to move it over. And I can move it to right here. I could have stopped here. But I'm going to go right here. And so you notice I'm on the kind of like the vertex right here. And now I'm just going to draw against the lines. There are no lines to follow down here. I'm just going to keep going. There, I've just created a rectangle on my triangular paper. Nothing fancy. Students probably could have done this since first grade. But the idea is how to use grid paper to assist us in our drawing. And of course, we've satisfied all the requirements of a rectangle in this case. Two pairs of parallel lines. There's one pair, and here's another pair. And most importantly, we've got four 90-degree angles. Now, in this case, we've got rectangular grid paper, and we want to draw a parallelogram. So, parallelogram, all right? Now, what is a parallelogram? Well, we know that a parallelogram has to have four sides, and we need two pairs of parallel lines. Okay, so what does that mean? Well, I'm going to start by drawing just one single line, and in this case, it happens to be 4 units in length. You could see 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's 4 units. And what I'm going to do is I am going to select this guy, and I'm going to duplicate him. So now I've got this guy. Now we know if I were to stop here, it looks like I'm about to make a rectangle. But to turn it into a parallelogram, watch what happens. I'm going to take this guy, and I'm just going to raise him up 1 or 2 units. It doesn't matter exactly how many units. I raised him up 2 units. Now, when I connect my dots, my lines, I'm going to go from here to here, and then here to here. I just created a parallelogram. Because what is a parallelogram? Well, it's got to have 4 sides, which it does, and it's got to have 2 pairs of parallel lines, but you don't need to have 90-degree angles. And sure enough, I don't have any 90-degree angles here. So I just created a parallelogram on this really nice grid paper. Now, if I wanted to create just any old quadrilateral on my rectangular grid paper, I could do that. I can do just any old quadrilateral. So 1, I could go here, I could go up 3, go here, and here. Now I have a quadrilateral, just 4 sides. There's no parallel lines, no sets of parallel lines. So that's called a quadrilateral. And I'm going to write that down here. Quadrilateral. But if I wanted to do it like a trapezoid, so it's got 2 lines that are parallel, so 1 pair of parallel lines. So I'm going to start by drawing a line, and then I'm going to draw another line parallel to that, but not quite as long. It doesn't have to be as long. So now I can grab that guy. Where is it? Yikes. Ungroup. And I want to unlock this guy. Unlock. Now can I grab him? All right, so now I'm going to take this line that I've drawn, and you can see it's parallel. And I'm just going to put it anywhere I want. Now, I could stop at any time, and let's stop right here. Okay. And now I'm going to connect my endpoints. Boom and boom. I now have a trapezoid. So this is a trapezoid because it only has 1 pair of parallel lines right here, and it has 4 sides, but only 1 pair parallel lines. So that's a quick, hint at how to use triangular paper and rectangular grid paper to draw some of our basic quadrilaterals. So let's put this into some practice. So it says, construct a quadrilateral with only 1 set of parallel sides. 1 set. Well, I kind of showed you that just previously. So I'm going to draw a line, and apparently I'm going to do it in green. And then I'm going to draw another length parallel, but not quite as long. And I'll just put it right here. And then when I connect the lines, the vertices in here, you can see I have a quadrilateral because there's 4 sides, but there's only 1 pair of parallel sides, 1 set of parallel sides. And what shape did I create? I created, in this case, a trapezoid. All right, in this one, we're going to draw a quadrilateral. It's got 1 set of parallel lines, but this time, it's got to have 2 right angles. So this is going to get a little tricky, and this is going to be fun. Let's see. So I'm going to start by drawing a line down here of any length, and then I'm going to draw a second line that is parallel to that first black one, only a different length. All right, so in this case I'm going to make it shorter, And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab it. Now, it's parallel still, but this time I'm going to move it to the left so that, oh, let's see, there it is, so that this corner and this corner are right on top of each other. And so what have I done? I have created two right angles, two 90-degree angles. You can see them right here. Here's a right angle, and here's a right angle. And now I'm going to connect these two vertices. And so I've got one set of parallel lines. Boom, boom. There's my one set of parallel lines. I've got two 90-degree angles, just like I was supposed to. And what shape did I create? I created a trapezoid. And the last slide for this video is we're going to construct a quadrilateral. We're going to have two sets of parallel sides. All right, and what shape did we create? So they didn't give us a lot of criteria, just quadrilateral, so it's got to have four sides. Four sides. And it's got to have two sets of parallel sides. So we have a bunch of choices here. Two sets of parallel sides. So we could, there, you can see two sets of parallel sides. There's one set of parallel sides, and there's another set of parallel sides. So what did we create? We just created a rectangle, but that's not the only answer that could have worked. We could have drawn, we could have drawn a parallelogram. We could have said, okay, let's draw one 3-unit length here. And then I could have drawn another 3-unit length, but slightly raised up a little bit right here. And then when I do that and connect these dots, I have two sets of parallel lines. There's one, there's a set, and there's a set right here, but I don't have a rectangle anymore. Now I have a parallelogram, but we didn't have to do that. Now, what could we have done? Oh, we could have done a rhombus. A rhombus would be a little bit trickier to draw on this figure, on this paper, but let's see. A rhombus could look like, oh, I could start here, and I could go over two, up three, then I could go over three, up three over two, and then I could go one, two, three, one, two, and then there is my rhombus. So I could draw a rhombus that looks like that. So I've drawn four sides, and they happen to all be equal sides in this case. But now we have one set of parallel lines and another set of parallel lines. So now I've just drawn a rhombus, and really, if I wanted to be super clear on this case, I could say that all four side lengths are the same, whereas up here I could say these two are the same and these two are the same. And similarly, I could say that this side is equal to this side, and this side, two lines, is the same length as this side, so congruent. So, man, on this figure, I could draw a square. I could draw a square, and I'm going to squeeze that in because it's so easy. Boom, 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 boom. There it is. There's a square, and it's a quadrilateral, and it's got two sets of parallel sides. Here's one set, and here's another set. So this question was really ripe, and we could have drawn any one of these four figures. And that wraps up Grade 4, Module 4, Lesson 16, talking about quadrilaterals and reasoning about their attributes.